Hi guys, welcome back. I hope everyone is good. Today we are going to discuss about multiple steps, one step definition. So in that we are going to show you some magics from cucumber latest basically. So we have one step here. You can see I proceed to payment success, I proceed to payment failure, and I proceed to payment in review. So what happens sometimes you are performing the same thing, but the statements are different, okay? Or you want to perform the almost same thing, but based on the condition, you want to change the code. So here also we have three steps here, but only one step definition will be there. How we can achieve it, let me show you. So, okay, now one more thing I have to discuss here. So here success, failure, and interview. In review, basically, we are not passing as an argument, but we'll receive as an argument because this word is only changing. Rest are all same. So in step definition, you can see I proceed to payment and three arguments I have given. If any one of these three arguments is coming, these steps will get executed. Okay, and we will receive this argument, this three argument in the form of argument here, string, and then we have written like what argument we are printing it, and then we can write if this is success. You print something like, okay, let's put it as success, or you can just, I'll just not put anything, just I'll put it success, okay, success. Then we have another is, okay, and then another we'll put it like else statement, if, and then we can put another statement here. And we will put the same argument, like we can compare with failure or whatever it is, and I will just put it failure. Okay, spelling of success is wrong. Okay, I'll correct it, no problem. Anyhow, and I can put the argument here like success and failure. Okay, and we put it here. Okay, so now what we have done is here three different steps, but the step definition is one. So what is the advantage of doing this? Like, we are saving lot of codes. Unnecessarily, we don't have to create a step, and might be some part of the code is same, only this based on the success and failure, we are writing some validations. Okay, so it will save some memories, initializations, objects, lot of things will save, and code will be crystal clear. And we are also removing the dead code, like unnecessary code we are writing for the same, redundant, we are removing it. Okay, so let me run it and see it how it's happening. Okay, I'll just run it. So in review it has printed failure, you can see failure here also, and success here also. So one step has done the magic. Okay, similar to this we have another way of doing it with this one, where not only the last word is changing, even the entire wording is also changing. We can have one step only. Okay, there are chances like in our step different in the steps we write some different wording, like verify XYZ in different screen, verify ABC in XYZ screen, but the task or the code is same. The method we have called it, or the method the steps we have written it, is almost same. So in that situation, you don't have to create different step definitions. You can have only one step definition, and we are not taking anything as argument. You can write argument also if you think, okay, no, based on the argument I have to take the decisions. Okay, you pass on argument, but from not from the step, but at the last word will be the argument. Even the last statement also you can put as an argument. Okay, I have just put the one word as an argument. I'm going to receive this as one word as an argument. So you can see it here. I log into a country. Sorry, not there. This one. Yeah, this one. I proceed to change password and window as an argument. I proceed to reset password Android. I proceed to unlock password iPhone. Okay. Only difference is the method will be synchronized one. So whenever any steps coming from feature file with the window, it will execute this one. Whenever it's coming with the Android, it will do this one. Even though it's coming with the iPhone, it will do this one. And we are receiving as an argument as a step, and we are performing based on the what is coming. If it is a window, it will perform this. If it is Android, it will perform this. If it is iPhone, it will perform this. Got it? So what is that one? Let's see how we can run it and see how it's working or not. Let's see. As I told you, the advantage, like, we are saving a lot of memories. Now, a lot of code, basically. Unnecessarily, we are not writing same steps again and again. Okay? So let me run it now. You can see it, iPhone, Android, and Window. Okay? So this is how we can achieve multiple steps from a feature file in one step definition. I hope you all like it. My code, I'll put the code repository also into the comment. Please do subscribe. Have a nice day, guys. Thank you.